Hi, my lovelies. I hope you're all doing really well. Today, I'm going to be doing pumpkin carving. So, I've never carved pumpkins before. But I thought it would be a really cute kind of thing for me to do for you. So if it goes massively wrong, then at least it'll probably be something for you to laugh at. And I just got a little pumpkin because we don't really celebrate Halloween in my house. So, once I'm done with this, we're probably going to cook it instead of have it outside getting rotten. And welcome to my kitchen. This is my mum and dad's kitchen. Obviously, as you know, well, you may know that I live with my mum and dad at the moment because I'm a student. But yeah. Isn't it beautiful? Hopefully I can do a few more videos with baking and cooking and things, because I know that a lot of you like drawer sounds and opening cupboards and getting things out and stuff. So hopefully you'll find this kind of atmosphere a bit relaxing. And I'm going to try my best. So, I'm going to try and take this sticker off because this pumpkin is a little bit wounded on the other side. So I'll just take the sticker off. Which may be more difficult than it looks. To do this because I have no idea whatsoever. And if you hear some snoozing or little footsteps, my puppy Dobby is just sleeping over here, but he might get up and have a walk around. We'll just have to see. So I've got this fish knife because I thought it's quite precise. Hopefully, anyway. But it does actually have a bend in the top. But I can't get that out. Okay. I don't want to make the circle on the top too big. I fruits and vegetables really difficult to cook. Not to cook, to cut. Like, for example, I love butternut squash. But my goodness, cutting it up is the most difficult thing. Maybe this wasn't the best knife. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna get a bowl to just put the waste in. I know I'm gonna need that later. I probably should have a chopping board as well, actually. I'm just gonna chop the messy bit off. There we go. So there's my top. Now's the interesting bit. I've got to try and scoop all this out in the centre. I don't know if you can see that, but I've just got new nails on, so that's going to be interesting. Right, I'll take my jewellery off. Okay, spoon, I think. I really don't know what I'm doing. Okay, well, this is like the sounds of like ear-licking videos without having to do ear-licking videos. Like that squishy wet sound. Oh, there's so many seeds in a pumpkin. You could make your own pumpkin field with just one pumpkin. Look at how many is there already. So this is going to be my front, and I've tried to empty it out as best as I can, but it smells so nice. Okay. I think what I'm going to do is take my little knife and carve out a little pattern first. So let's just get a pattern up. So, I'm gonna carve the eyes. hopefully this will work, but we'll see. Okay. So how deep is it? Okay, that's deep enough. So it's really, it's quite square, but I suppose that once you've cut the initial shape, you know what? Looking from my pumpkin carving skills, you'd never be able to tell that I was an artsy person, would you? I mean, his eyes aren't the shape that his eyes are supposed to be. At all. Oh dear. Okay, if I carve a bit more. Okay. Oh no, his eyes are massive, but they are the right shape now. That looks a bit better, doesn't it? Okay, next eye. His eyes are just massive. No idea how well this video is gonna go. We'll just have to be hopeful. Eyes aren't really meant to be symmetrical, so I suppose that kind of works. Okay, now for the nose, which I think is going to be the tricky part. actually the first video I've recorded in 3 weeks since I've been back at university. Because I've been crazy busy. As you know, if you follow me on Twitter, I got the part that I wanted, which means that I've got a lot of lines to learn, which is a good thing, and I'm very happy that I got the part. But it also means that I'm very, very busy all the time. But I'm just gonna have to learn to cope with it, basically. Who said pumpkin carving was easy, hey? There we go. Okay. You know what's funny? My house never stops making noises. So one thing turns on, and then another thing turns on once that's turned off. And then an aeroplane goes overhead, or a bird starts tweeting, or the dog starts barking. I can never get silence. I don't know how much light that's gonna let through, but it will have to do. I'm nearly done now. I'm just doing his little stitches now on his mouth. Which is so fiddly. Go right on cue, the birds have started tweeting. Started making noises. The inside is very messy. So after the video, I'm gonna wash it out. And hopefully when the evening time comes, I will put a candle in and I'll record it for you outside so you can see what it looks like. But here we go. So it's a little Jack Skellington. And do you know what? I'm actually really proud of that. Put the top on. There we go. So this is my mess left over, which I've just got all over the table. I'm gonna have so much fun washing up after this. Okay. So, I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I know it's been a bit strange. There's probably been a lot of background noises and me not talking and focusing, but I hope that me doing a task was somewhat relaxing, or you've enjoyed the atmosphere of the kitchen, or, oh, I don't know, even just my voice. I hope that you have a fabulous Halloween week. Don't get into too much trouble and don't eat too many sweets. I love you all very, very much. And here is now a clip of the jack-o'-lantern